takeaways from the last time that you played them here? I mean, obviously it was close, 80-75. That game went into overtime, but it seemed that they just had something. Maybe it was just their size. They just kind of prevented you guys from really being close to them.
I remember we started out the game really well. I thought we played with a lot of energy. I think we're long, but they're long also. And I thought, not unlike last game, the offensive boards, they did a good job there. Pirtle hurt us in the second half, and especially in the overtime when we played against them last time. They kind of just continued to stay the course in how they were playing, and we would go up, we would make a run, and they remained steady, and they were able to pull out the victory.
And then you went back and watched the film on Saturday. What stood out about why Arizona was able to get to the offensive glass as much as they were?
You know, Andrew Andrews pulled down a rebound against Washington State there, where he just willed his way to get it. When we played Utah last time, there was a play where Matisse Thybulle was on the wing and almost had the ball, didn't quite have it, and just willed his way, might even grab the guy's jersey a little bit, and just went after the ball and got it, led to a dunk. That's kind of what happened down the stretch. They just kind of willed their way to some rebounds and were able to get the ball. Like I said, after the game, they ended up with a lot of offensive rebounds, but one guy had 8 of them. He just was determined to go get that basketball.
Is there a way to counter that, Will?
He didn't do it as much last time. And Ryan Anderson, I think, is one of the best offensive rebounders in the league, and we have to have the same will.
What makes this road trip one of the most difficult in the conference?
Because they're two good teams, for starters. And combined, I don't know if they've lost more than 2 or 3 games combined at home this year. That in itself makes it a challenge.
Is altitude a factor at all on this trip? I've been to Colorado. Just don't even mention it.
Not my opinion. I did play once at a time, and I played in that altitude. And the first time we played there, guys were making mention that at the end of the game, it's too much altitude got to me. When I experienced it, got to you at first. At first, you feel like your lungs are burning. You feel like, wait a minute, am I out of shape all of a sudden? Did I not get enough rest? But after a few times down the floor, you're okay. So I always feel like that is that's a mental thing that, as much as you want to talk about it and let it get to you, it can get to you. That's how I feel. It is a factor if you allow it to be a factor.
What harder is Pirtle to guard this season than he was for you guys last year?
He's so much more active this year. Last year, DeLon Wright did quite a bit of their scoring, and he kind of played off of him, but he also was in foul trouble a lot last year. So a lot of time he wasn't in the game, but this year he's so much more active. He's so much more mobile. He can actually put the ball on the floor and go to the rim. And then he probably had this in him, but he's using it much more than the pass. They scored 6 points off of us last time just because he passed the ball. You step up, he passes it right away. So if you double him, if you're not totally organized, he's going to find the open guy. And they shoot the ball so well, it hurts you.
From that first game, the 29 points or whatever, got to the free throw line so many times. Is there anything you see from that you go, okay, well, we just didn't do this right, and if we clean this up, we'll be okay? Or did he just kind of dominate, so to speak?
When you look at his points, I think he had 27. 4 of them were off of us missing assignments on out of bounds plays. He had 4 free throws. There were 3 switches that we didn't execute. He scored off those, so there were 10 points just off of our lack of switching. He scored 4 points. Transition, where he got ahead of the pack once. And another time we kind of lost him in transition. He scored that way. He scored, I believe, 6 points off of them running good offense and getting him the basketball. And they practiced too. He scored that. So there's 20 right there. He scored in a lot of different ways. There wasn't just one way. He just got us.
And
that's a credit to him as a basketball player.
Is it easier for this defense to maybe lock in on a opposing guard who's really going off, with the way that you guys play defense, as opposed to a big man who is down low, and then those switches create the mismatches?
It's like anything else. It's if we played a pack defense where we didn't pressure at all, if there are breakdowns within that pack defense, you have flaws within your execution. Maybe not in the defense itself. If the defense is executed properly, it serves you a lot better. And I think there are times that, and we've got better at it, but there are times when we simply have breakdowns. And if we were playing zone, if we were playing regular man-to-man, whatever it is, if you have breakdowns in anything that you run, it could look like you're not being effective. Our breakdowns, I think, are diminishing now. I thought in the Arizona game, we played maybe as good a defense as we played. There are a lot of positives, but Arizona's a good team. Ryan Anderson's a good player, but I don't think it had a whole lot to do with the switches. In fact, there were many, many times, I think people see the times when they get by and score, but if you added them all up, that's not what beat us.
In the past, you've been able to kind of mix maybe your primary defense in with some zone occasionally, maybe out of a timeout or something like that. On Saturday, it seemed like there was a couple occasions where you were starting. Ideally, is that kind of the maturation of this team in terms of their ability maybe to throw something like that out there and adjust?
Sure. And we did do that. If you saw that, you got good eyes, because we played several zone possessions. In fact, one of them bit us. It was a big one. It was toward near the end of the first half, and we were supposed to be in zone, and guys forgot, and York got open, wide open for a three. That was because we were supposed to be in zone, and one guy thought we were a different defense. But for the most part, when we did go zone, we either forced a turnover or they didn't take a good shot. So yeah, as this team begins to grasp things, as now we only have 7 regular season games left, maybe we can add some more things. Because with this group, I talked about the balance of moving on and being patient, and you start doing too many things, you become a jack of all trades, a master of none. We don't want to be that team. So we've still been trying to get this defense together, and I thought we made great strides the last couple of games.
I know you're always eager to tell us how important every game is, but how excited are you to see how this team responds as the stakes get higher and higher, knowing your position in the league right now, knowing where your RPI is, knowing how close you are to getting to where you want to go? How excited are you to kind of see their reaction?
Each day is a new day, presents a different challenge. But I think the stakes were pretty high against Arizona. I think the stakes were really high, and I thought our guys did a tremendous job. We left probably 10 points out there on the floor with maybe shots that were too quick. We're turning the ball over when we had opportunities to score. We left those out there. Some defensive situation where we had them stop, the shot clock runs down, and we foul at the end of the shot clock and give them new life. But I thought our guys did a really good job, and I say that